Hi, I'm here with Strength Project, and we're going to show you some simple exercises to help you get your plange. If you want to learn your plange, the first exercise you should master is a simple L sit, and it should look like this. Hips are forward, legs are straight out, arms are straight. After you're able to hold your L, you should also be able to hold your position and retract your legs to a tucked position, and that should look like this. Once you can hold the tuck support, the next element is rotating your hips a quarter turn to the plange position and try to momentarily hold that, and you can rock back and forth to that position until it gains strength, and that should look like this. Once you're strong enough to maintain a tucked plange position, you can now experiment with extending one leg out or two legs out for a momentary hold in a straddle or even legs together to hold that plange position. And that would look like this. One thing you'll notice, but may not be evident, is the technique. A plange should be done with locked out arms, so your arms are straight, and your upper shoulders should be nice and round, what we call a hollow body position. And this will give you the most strength and engage your back muscles, the largest muscles in your body. So when you're beginning, the tucked hold should look like this. Arms are straight. My body is away from my arms, so I'm not supporting myself with my arms. This is the position you'd like to get stronger. Straight arms, nice round hollow body. Once you begin to get stronger in that hollow body tucked plange position, a nice thing to work on to help lock the arms out and gain more strength is by doing a small dip in that tucked plange position, and that would look like this. Tucked plange, bend, push, bend, push. So it's literally a push-up in that tucked plange position. Now we're using canes or pedestals to demonstrate how to work on your plange, but you don't need anything at all. You can simply use the ground for holding your tuck planges, and that would look like this. Your tucked plange is the foundation for learning your straight body plange. And initially, most people struggle with being able to get their hips up to the proper position. If you're struggling with this, then it's the shoulder strength that you need to work on, because in order for the hips to rise to the right position, your shoulders have to lean forward. So an exercise you can do for that is simply leaning forward in a push-up position so that you become stronger, and again, bend and straighten the arms. As you elevate the feet higher and higher, it's going to load your shoulders and increase your strength. So this is an example of raising the feet and putting more load on the shoulders to strengthen that plange position. I lean forward, much like the plange, bend and straighten the elbows. When you're ready to advance your plange push-up, a good thing to be able to use is either a chair, or in this case, I'm going to use my pedestal or cane, and I'm going to allow it to tip forward so I'm balancing with my shoulders and then do my push-up from there. I find my plange position, my shoulders are directly over my hands, and I lean forward to the plange position. So there's a more delicate balance here. And then I initiate my push-up here. It's important that you lock out your body and your upper back, and your elbows are straight in order to hold this position. Now the last thing I want to mention is hand placement. There's no real right or wrong way to place your hand. It depends if you're doing it on the ground or on pedestals. That hand placement may vary. You want to place your hands in a position that will allow you to most importantly keep that nice round hollow position, and that uses the strength of your back to hold the planche. Your elbows are straight, so the technique is good. The hand placement might vary according to your body and your technique. I'm Sam from Spinnovation. Thanks for watching. My name is Sam Tribble, and I practice the performing art of Simple Wheel. I was introduced to it by a friend of mine, and I fell in love with practicing it. It was just a lot of fun, so I just kept practicing it. And now people ask if I want to do an art opening or, you know, the entertainment for their party. What the Simple Wheel does for me